So when you hang out with a dog like Kyler here, it's impossible not to wonder if they're reading our minds. Does he know what I'm thinking? Does he know how I'm feeling? And that's actually an important question that a lot of scientists have been working on. And the reason that people have been interested scientifically in this is because we know that when children begin to read the minds of others, it's when they start to participate in culture. It's even how they start to learn language. And what we know is that animals do have some ability to think about others thinking. We know, for instance, that chimpanzees know when others can or can't see something. But what about dogs? What about our best friends? Can they also think about what we're thinking about? Can they read our minds? And the answer is yes. In some situations, dogs are actually the best at understanding humans, better than almost any other animal that's ever been studied. What they're really, really good at is reading our gestures. So if I point in a direction or if I look in a direction and I'm trying to communicate something to Kyler here, he's really good at figuring out what it is that I'm trying to tell him relative to other animals when we give other animals that same kind of problem. Right, Kyler?
Yes, you are very good at that. You are very good at that.
Does that tell us why some dogs grow up to be really good service dogs? Kyler's in a service dog program himself. Why is it that some of the puppies like Kyler are successful with service dog training and others are not? And one of the things we found is that the dogs that are best at thinking about the thoughts of humans are reading our minds using our gestures. They're the most likely to do well. Now, there are limits to what dogs can do in terms of reading our minds. Right now, based on the best science, there's no evidence that dogs can understand that another dog or another person has a belief, or even more complicated, a false belief, that you know something that's incorrect. That as far as we know, humans are the only animal that can do that. And we think that's probably why we end up developing language and having a very rich cultural life, whereas animals, including Kyler here, they don't develop those things. Kyler, you're amazing, man. I've done this with lots of different animals. Doesn't always go this well.